Well, here we are on the weekend at the S&S Turbines main shop. And some of you may recognize this from the engineering section of the Starship Enterprise in the reboot of Star Trek 2009. Actually, it's the compressor cases for an LM2500 that we have a fairly interesting story about, a lot of people ask to see what the engines look like when they come in here before they're all refurbished and repaired and rejuvenated and they're at our test cell and running and doing their thing. So I haven't really showed a whole lot of that. I'm going to try to do that with this 2500, although it's already been taken apart and much of it's been refurbished, but I have some pictures of what it looked like when it came in here. We have some of the pieces. We're going to take a look at those and we're going to show that we make everything new again. We fix your problems because we do services, maintenance, overhauls, and repairs. And this engine basically turned into a repair overhaul, an overhaul repair, a complete newification. So let's take a look at this a little bit closer and then some other pieces. All right, these are the compressor cases of an LM2500 that when it came in, there was no real damage to the compressor, but it was very dirty and somewhat corroded. So Walter and Dana and Gabe and Andre have gone through this and it's looking beautiful. I don't think any of the parts have been replaced, but they have been cleaned up and returned to serviceable condition, which is great. Let's take a look at, this is the forward end of the compressor. This is the rear end. These are all the stators. What goes on the front here is the front frame. We'll take a look at that. It's been cleaned up and polished, or cleaned up and painted actually. I don't know if it's been polished, but it's been painted. It looks great. Hang on. This is the repainted front frame of an LM2500. And the first thing that you see on this engine, when you're looking into the intake or the inlet, are these struts. Now these are immensely strong. This is a steel front frame. And these spokes, there are five of them. They are so strong you can't even believe it. What would it take to bend or twist one of these? It would first take a lot of heat, possibly a massive impact like a truck hitting the engine, or if it was in a plane it would take, well, you know. But these, what they do is they support with great precision. It's the position of the front bearing, which is what holds the front of the shaft of the compressor in place. So obviously the struts don't move. The next thing you're going to see as the engine's running are the first stage stators. They're right there on the bottom, right down there, and they do move. They're all linked together, so I can't, well, I can move one. Let's see if we can make the first one move. Not so much rotate, but revolve. Yeah, there we go. See, they move. They're all connected with a rack. This one is connected to, I think, on the other side. And so the bars, the rings that actuate them are connected by a brace that goes into these two holes. So they're all coordinated, but I can move this individual one. It's kind of cool. Okay, so what turns right there is the stage one compressor disc. We'll take a look at that. Okay, we happen to have the rotor from this engine on the balance machine, and these are the stage one compressor blades. It would turn this way in operation, and this is the first thing you would be able to see, but of course it's behind the stators, behind the struts, and that's probably the source of one of the most popular questions on my channel, which is, why isn't the fan turning? Okay, so there is no fan on a 2500. The 2500 is the same thing as a CF6 airliner engine. CF6 has, through this hole, through the front, another shaft passing through, and then a giant fan on the front. So technically this is not called the fan, but you can't see these blades very well. I try to show them on a startup. They're not the first thing you see in the engine. Okay, so this is beautiful. This has been cleaned up through weeks of effort of hand cleaning, mostly by Dana. And it was very corroded and very dirty, light corrosion on the surface, and a lot of soot and dirt from operating in a basically an industrial environment. All that smoke, soot, whatever from other diesel engines and other equipment gets basically concentrated because so much air goes through this compressor during its lifetime. Millions and billions and billions of cubic feet of air. So that particulate matter in the air gets deposited in the compressor. This has really been cleaned up nicely. It did not look like this when it came in. Unfortunately, we don't have any pictures, but we have pictures of other things. We have some pictures of the turbine blades in situ. Now some pictures of the turbine stators, or the nozzles we call them, the turbine nozzle, turbine stators. We have pictures of those. And let's go out to the sea containers where we store the parts that we take off of engines and stuff that either can or even can't be repaired because you never know, you might have a use for them. Let's take a look at that. So we store everything here at S&S, even the parts that are damaged, because you never know when you can use them to make tooling or mock-up or something like that. So let's take a quick look at some of the parts that came off of that ill-fated LM2500. So, there's an interesting detail we'll talk about in a minute. But anyway, this is the turbine rear frame. Those are the struts, and you can see that they are torn open. Things are not looking good. This engine was just about ready to donate some pieces to the world. Holy mackerel. Anyway, what I find unusual here is in the storage area, this stuff can't be fixed. This is gonna be replaced. That's pretty savage damage in there. So interestingly enough, we have them labeled with green tags. That's pretty funny. I guess the person wasn't quite aware of what tags are for, or maybe we were out of red ones, but this is definitely red tag territory. So funny that. Anyway, that's what it used to look like. And now standing up here, we're looking at, these are the second stage HPT nozzles, because you can see below them is the blade track of the first stage turbine. And so the first stage nozzles would have been ahead of these, but even so, these would be the third hottest things in the engine, and you can see that they're feeling uncomfortable in their job. They're starting to lighten the load, losing pieces as we go, getting smashed into things. So this was probably an emergency shutdown, or possibly just lucky, I guess. There's a bad piece there. All of this is junk, can't be saved. Possibly the outer casing. The turbine shrouds are thrashed, smashed, and bashed. So they will have to be replaced. Of course, all the nozzles, the seals, possibly the outer case, although that's looking like some damage there, almost going right through. And very interesting. It was a very interesting thing to look at when it came in the shop, and also to pick apart and see the savages and ravages of what can happen when things are pushed a little too hard. That's ready to blow chunks right there. Look at that. Pieces already gone and about to leave. Wow, amazing. And as a special treat, right here, right there, I have the turbine blades, stage two turbine blades, as removed from the engine. You're gonna find this interesting. So let's take a closer look. There's a whole box of them, and you can tell they were experiencing great pain. This red dust here is just, that's part of the concentrated contents of the air. This red dust is in all the engines that we see here when we first get them. We clean all that off. But these we haven't bothered to clean because they basically can't be reused. They can't be rehabilitated. The metal's got sort of a pewtery sheen to it normally. And it gets rough like sandpaper and then crispy like an old cracker. This has been massively overheated. And of course, pieces have been flying off. This is in very, very bad shape. This is essentially, well, it is scrap, but there's another interesting feature here. Let's see if I had a little pointer. Okay, if you look closely at this poor, ravaged, savaged, and now dead blade. Can you see that? That groove? That means, and that was, okay, that's the leading edge. There's the trailing edge there. Leading edge is thicker. It's basically missing here, but here's a better one. There's the leading edge. And look at that. That's been grinding against something. So what was happening is the gases are blowing this way with great force, and the stage one nozzle was being pushed up, bent up into the spinning turbine disc. It would be going this way, and that was grinding in there. So the engine was melting and pieces were falling off, and it was also sawing itself to pieces. So very, very lucky that things didn't go bang. Now, there are some salvageable pieces from this engine, none of which are in view at this time in this video. These are junk, garbage. They can be saved as scrap and then melted down for material, possibly to make new turbine blades, but more likely just to become part of a high quality steel alloy. There's quite a bit of nickel in these, so they're valuable. Anyway, I often get questions about, well, what do these things look like when they're damaged or needing repair? And this is a very good example of when things get a little too hot, certain molecules decide they don't like it and they decide to leave very quickly out the back. All right, so when these blades, the pieces of them, were leaving at high speed out the back of the engine, they would be glowing orange hot. And so we call that chiclets. It looks like fluorescent orange chiclets flying out the back of the engine. It's a sign that things are going very bad very quickly. The 2500 is a gas generator for a power turbine, so that would not have been visible. The engine is connected by a duct to a large power turbine. So there may have been, I don't know the story of this engine, but there may have been vibration sensors that were, or there would have been vibration sensors. There may have been alarms, the gauges or the numerical readouts or even electronic alarms would be going off because the engine would be massively out of balance because these pieces don't all leave at the same time. Chunks fly off, goes out of balance and starts to really shake the bearings. So that would be one thing. Possibly even the exhaust stack of the power turbine, there was probably bits flying out of there. Don't know, but this engine was shut down just in time. Just in time. This is quite amazing. We don't often see stuff like this. We like to catch it before. That's why during the life cycle of an engine, especially an industrial one, the vibration monitoring is quite sophisticated, so you can detect this kind of stuff before it gets this bad. Like I said, I don't know the history of this engine, but I do know that when it's put together with new parts, it's going to run great. We're going to video it and we're going to ship it back to the customer and they are going to love it. So, cool. These blades, they actually belong to the customer. So they're not available to us or anybody else. I'll try to find out from the owners if they're available to trade, but possibly. These are very interesting. You don't very often see stuff like this. Overheated and blown apart. Super cool. Actually, not super cool, super heated. We're way above the shelf, so we're gonna try our best to show you with a flashlight. The combustor and the fuel nozzle mounts for the LM2500 engine. It's a 35,000 horsepower net output, burns a lot of fuel. Anyway, you can see the liner is dirty and got a lot of that red dust in it, but there's no real damage. It's ceramic coated and it can produce a lot of heat. And the 2500 runs at a hotter temperature than the 1500, which is why we don't see damage to the blades like we did over there to the 1500 very much. The 2500 has air-cooled blades and has a much higher running temperature. Anyway, you can tell that they were giving it a bit too much gas, I think, because the combustor's fine and all that roaring heat coming out of there, that was what began to stress and then eventually destroy the turbine nozzles and turbine blades and also the liner of the The turbine housing, the turbine frame. Yes. So the compressor and the combustor was fine. After that, a little too much heat. Little too much heat for the situation at hand. Things start to fly away. All right, there's the beautiful front frame. There's a front frame of a 1500 over there in the top right. There's the back end of a 1500. And then those beautiful Star Trek props, the LM2500 compressor cases. I hope this little tour of the damaged and ravaged parts of the before condition of a damaged engine was entertaining to you. A lot of people ask about seeing that kind of stuff. We tend to focus on what it's like when we're done with it and it's testing in the test cell. And as for me showing footage of how that kind of damage happens, I don't have any because basically it doesn't happen here and I'm not on site when any of these problems happen with engines. And it's like trying to predict a traffic accident. So there is no footage in my possession of things burning up and damaging, things like that. So this huge rig here is lifted by the crane. This is how you install the turbine rotor in an LM2500. It's a big, heavy, cumbersome tool, and it is how you put the two halves together. It's very cool. The tool for the 1500 is a lot smaller, but the 2500 is a great big monster of an engine. From the engineering deck of the Starship Enterprise, I thank you once again for watching.